Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another small build guide for Path of Exile 3.15. And it's another new gem, it's Explosive Concoction. And yeah, hopefully this will work, because I'm pretty hyped about the skill, to be honest. It looks great and has a lot of damage potential. If it can shotgun and with greater multiple projectiles, you can hit the same target twice or three times. That's insane damage potential. That's why I skilled point blank. If it doesn't, it does not shotgun and you can stay at range, point blank loses its value and we skip it. So let's get to the skill and let's look at it. It's like a flask that we throw and it explodes as soon as it hits, I guess, an enemy or the floor, and yeah, explodes. It has a fire coat and lightning tech that makes it pretty easy to scale. The biggest problem is that you can't have a weapon in your main hand. That was something that did throw me off a bit, but yeah, I think I fixed it. So let's get back to the skill tree, and yeah, as you can see, Wind Dancer for a bit of defensive, but the big thing as we play it as Pathfinder, cause Explosive Concoction uses your flask charges to deal damage. How this works, it uses your Sapphire Topaz flask to add damage. Sapphire flask cold damage and Topaz flask lightning damage. So you lose some flask charges, but you deal more damage. Ruby flask is only ignite multiplier. Maybe that works too, if you play ignite build, but I don't. So I had to figure out a way to keep the flask charges up. And who can do this better than Pathfinder? So we use Nature's Boom for flask charges every second. 20% chance to not consume charges. I guess this will work with Explosive Concoction, but even if it doesn't, should still be fine. With Master Alchemist for more elemental damage, chance to shock freaks and ignite, yeah, that's fine. And the big thing is Veteran Bowyer. The physical damage as extra damage of a random element is useless, but Ele penetration, and the big thing is the line at the bottom. Enemies you kill that are affected by elemental ailments grant 100% increased flask charges. That should keep us up in the flasks. So it should be pretty easy. So what else do we got? Nothing really out of the ordinary, nothing fancy, a lot of life. Bit of blast radius. As you can see, it's not crit, it's only elemental overload build. We should be fine on crit, so we throw so many projectiles, that should be okay. And yeah, this is my no cluster tree, and of course I have a cluster tree too. Looks a bit different, not that big. We use an elemental cluster with area of effect, red spread destruction, area of effect, elemental damage. Corrosive elements is a huge thing, cause yeah, this skill has three tags. It deals fire, cold and lightning damage if we use the right flasks. And every throw should apply at least one exposure. And if you can get all three exposures, that's huge. As far as I know, maybe that's wrong, but as far as I know, exposures stack, but not on the same element. So a cold exposure would replace an occult exposure, what a fire exposure would stack with a cold exposure. So you have both of them on the enemy and yeah, would have minus 25 resistance. I think it's minus 25 to both of the elements. And then Prismatic Heart for a bit of more of damage. We have one medium jewel for crit, so we proc Elemental Overload more often. We have this right here, attack speed, move speed if you crit recently, and critical strike chance. That's just a really good note. And basics of pain, damage and critical strike chance. Yeah, pretty easy. On the bottom we have powerful assault, increased area damage, and area skills have 10% chance to knock enemies back on hit. And towering threat, area damage and bit of life. Easy. Really easy. The skills. Let's start with explosive concoction. I know. That says elemental hit, but let's just ignore that and think it's explosive concoction. We use increased area of effect. Of course, single target, you might want to use conk effect. If it does shotgun, you might stick with area of effect, but yeah, that's something that we see. Elemental damage with attacks. Pretty basic. Inspiration to get a bit of elemental damage multiplier. Crit chance for our elemental overload. Yeah, and reduced mana cost. That's another big thing. GMP, pretty basic. More projectiles is more damage. And Trinity. We have such a huge variety on all three of our damage types, fire, cold, and lightning, that Trinity should always be stacked on all elements, especially with greater multiple projectiles or lesser multiple projectiles in the beginning. So Trinity is a big boost if you can have the elements stacked, the resonance of the elements. And this build should be pretty good for it. The next thing is shear charge in our helmet for being fast. We have in the gloves, we have Flame Dash, Lightning Golem, Blood Rage. Flame Dash just to get up and down cliffs or skip a beam or something. In our shield, we have Tempest Shield. You can just socket it on left click, put it on left click and have it up all time as soon as the cooldown refreshes. We have Wrath as an aura. Pretty easy. Aspect of the Spider. Yeah, we come to this. Chill. in our boots, we have Arcanist Brand with Sniper's Mark, Flame Wall, and Faster Casting. Flame Wall should be another huge burst single target. Boost, not burst. Single target for our projectiles. Should work. It did work with everything else I played last league that had projectiles, so should be fine. And we only use Arcanist Brand for single target anyway, so yeah. Our items. Our main hand is free, as you can see. Nothing there, because we can't have a weapon in our main hand. In our offhand, our shield, we use Liko Zidai, so we don't have to worry about the hit chance. We always hit, it can't be evaded. That's pretty good. It has a bit of life on it, so win for us. Our helmet is pretty basic. Life, resistance, body armor the same, life, resistance. Grip gloves is crafted with, what is it called? Essence. And I think I want to get the attack and cast speed essence, but it's just a quality of life feature. So it's not that necessary. If you can get it, use it. The base, the grip gloves, increased projectile attack damage is just a small increase. So we take it if we can. If not, hey, skip it. We have so many increases. Sling boots, as you can see, movement speed, resists, life, and aspect of the spider skill. Aspect of the spider skill is a pretty good aura that saves a lot of headache. We get something defensive from the slow, for the, what do you call them? The enemies. And it's a damage multiplier. So, hey, we take it. Maybe Spider is a bit expensive in the beginning, but it should get pretty affordable as long as the leak gets. So after 1, maybe 2 weeks, you can get it for half an exalt maybe. So it should be fine. Ember Amulet, as you can see, strength, Life, Elemental Damage with Attack Skills, Opal Rings, same, Resist, Strength, Life, The Belt, Stygian Vice. That's something, the belt is something that we want to have an eye on, a bit focus, because it has some decent Flast notes, and Flast charges used and Flast effect duration is pretty good for us. Yeah, we really want that. Searching Eye in my Stygian Vice with added damage, as you can see, blind enemies on hit with attacks can be phasing, but you want something with added damage, life, and another mod if you can get it. Now we come to our flasks. Here's my Topaz flask. Yeah, that's just for the damage increase. We don't press that button. Life flask, instant recovery, maybe poison remove on use. Sapphire flask, that's the big thing. We want to use the Sapphire flask with an instilling orb. That's the one, the new orb that uses your flask as soon as something happens. We want to instill orb our Sapphire flask till it says will be used if frozen or chilled. I guess that's what the mod will be called, something along those lines. And then we just forget it. Just put it in your belt next to your Topa flask and don't press it. It's gone. Don't even think about it. Quicksilver flask, of course, gotta go fast. If you have to dodge something, press it. You now have to think about pressing the Quicksilver flask a bit more, because yeah, the flask charges, the flask system gets reworked in 3.15, and they don't want you to play flask piano, so you have to think about it a bit more maybe. The last flask, it's an aquamarine right now, because I had to figure something out. We needed one flask that's up all the time, and I settled on the new flask. It's Corundum flask. Let me just show you what that is. It's this one here. It says increased stun threshold and cannot be stunned if you've been stunned during flask effect. That's pretty good. We don't have any stun immunity in this build. And yeah, that's our flask that we pretty much always have active. You use it close as soon as it is off use, or what do you call it, the duration is over, you press it again, and so on. You want to have it active all the time. Cause of being Pathfinder. Pathfinder is pretty nice for Flast, as you can see, nature's adrenaline, movement speed, attack speed, yeah, pretty good. So, yeah. And Master Alchemist, increased elemental damage. If it doesn't get changed, I don't have all the patch notes in my head right now. But yeah, this should be really a good starter, to be honest. Not sure when you can use the skill. Give me 1 second. You can start at level 28. So until then, just play some elemental skill, Rain of Arrows, anything, Toxic Rain maybe, everything should be fine to get to that point. So yeah, thank you all for watching, that's it, and I hope you have a great league, and goodbye.